Hello folks and fellow whistlers, good day, welcome back to another video here on my channel. Well, today we are going to the cold land of Sweden, because today we are going to play a song from this delicious Swedish meatballs. Yeah, I am talking about my friends from the band Grimner, because today we are going to play the song Infallen Jätte. I hope I spelled that right. I'm sorry, my Swedish got a little bit rusty over the years. But yeah, I already did a cover of this song. This song is awesome, so lovely and nice, catchy melody, and it's so nice to play. Yeah, for this song you need a whistle in the key of D, so this is a standard whistle, everybody has that at home, and if you haven't got this kind of whistle, look down in the comments, I post a link over there where you can get your first D whistle, pretty cheap, perfect for beginners, and yeah. What I wanted to say about this song is that actually there's a lot of whistle melody in the song, so that means that we have to learn a lot of different parts, and what I figured out while doing the sheet paper for this is the fact that to create the sheet paper, that's no problem for me, that's easy peasy, it's a nice word, but it's a little bit complicated for me to like divide the song in different parts, especially when you have like songs from Grimner, for example. They have a lot of melody parts, a lot of whistle parts, and also the row of how you play them is changing over the song or while the song. So for me, it's a little bit hard to like divide it in parts that everybody understands that, because you have to know, I never learned like classical music theory or something like this. I mean, when I was 7, I had like trumpet lessons by a teacher, but you know how it is when you're young and starting to do music and stuff, you don't know how the world works and how everything works out. So everything, all the instruments and every song I taught by myself, so actually, it's a little bit hard for me because I, of course, when I write this kind of tunes and when I learn tunes, I divide it with my own mind, but for me it's hard to like create it for you or create it to the people that everybody understands it. So if in this tutorial right now, if there's something unclear or that you don't understand how I divided the parts or why I play this now or something like this, if there are any questions at all, please write it down in the comments, because then you are helping me out, because I maybe figure out how you wanted to have the different parts divided for the upcoming how to play videos. And also I can help you to understand the song better and to learn the song. But yeah, I think we are just going to start right now and hope that I'm not confusing you so much with all these different parts. So, got your D whistle? Check. Got your awesome pajama pants? Check. Okay, so let's start with the intro part of Infallen Jätte by Grimner. Okay, so now we are starting with the intro of Infallen Jätte, and I divided this intro into a part A and a part B, and then at the end we have a part B2, which is actually the same as the normal part B, except for the ending, because then we are like closing the melody with some different notes over there. But first of all, we are starting with the part A of the intro. There you have everything you need to play along with me, and the first part of the intro goes like this. So this was part A of the intro. Let's play it again. Then we have part B, which goes like this. Once again. This was actually part B, and the part B2 at the end, there we have a little, some notes are changing, or you play some notes more, and actually there you have a half note you have to play. It's the G sharp, and you play it by covering the third hole from above, half with your finger, and I will just play part B2 for you, and it goes like this. So it's exactly the same as part B, except for the ending. You have this. So actually this was the whole intro. So you play the part A, part B, part A, and then the part B2. I will play the whole intro now for you, and it will sound like this. So actually this was the whole intro. I know this G sharp, it sounds a little bit like it's really hard to play, to cover like half of the hole with your finger and to make a nice and clear and clean tone out of it. And I understand, for example, if you have a whistle that is a little bit cheaper or something like this, it can sound a little bit off, but don't worry, it's just this one time where you have to play this half note, and also with a good whistle. This is a Berg whistle, by the way, I'm playing here right now. I will also post a link for this whistle down in the checkbox. Even with this whistle, for me it's hard to play this half note, especially when the melody is faster or stuff like this. It's really hard to like hit the hole in the right position, right direction with your finger. It just needs some training, but I know you can do it. This was the intro part, and after that we have the verse number one. I call it verse number one, yeah. Is something like also the melody part. And yep, let's take a look at that part, and let's do it. Okay, so now we're going to play the verse number one. I call it like this. Can be something different, but in my head, in my mind, I call it verse number one. I divided this part in part A and part B. It plays right after the intro, so you're sliding from the intro right into this first verse part. and part A of it goes like this. So at the beginning of the part A, you have four times this B note. You can like make a cut between this four B notes with your tongue. You can like but of course you can also play an ornament there how you like it. You can make like a roll, something like this, and it will sound like this. Sorry, once again. This is part A of the melody, and part B goes like this. Once again, we play the part B of the verse, and then we are going to play the whole verse together. So this was part B of the verse. I know that maybe the different parts all sound a little bit the same and just some notes are changing. I know it's confusing first, but you have the sheet paper. Just practice slow part by part, and once it's in your head, you will never forget that. Like, I learned this song, I have to look it up, but maybe 2 years ago, 3 years ago? And I still can play it. I didn't have to practice that at all. So once you learn it, you will never forget it. It will never get out of your head. Okay, so let's play the part A and part B of the verse together. So this is the verse, the first verse, all together, and after that we are going actually to verse 2. Verse 2. I called it verse 2. So from the worst verse ever, we are going to the second one. Yeah, let's do it. We can do it. I don't. Okay, so now we have the second verse. I call it second verse. If anybody says something else, then okay, that's fine. But that's how I made it up my mind. And this special thing about this second verse, which comes right after the first verse, is the fact that I divided it into a part A, B, C, and D. The reason for that is that these parts are changing over the whole song. So the first time we play the second verse, you play all parts. You play A, B, C, and D. The second time you play the verse, you only have the part B, which comes right before the break, and after the break part, you have the second verse again, but there you only play part A. So that's changing. First time, all four parts, second time only part B, and third time only part A. So that's why I divided it into these four little parts. I really hope it's not too confusing. If it is, I apologize already. Then I suggest you to get another teacher. Watch some other videos. Watch, I don't know. But yeah, or maybe tune in for the next video where I hopefully make it a little bit better and understandable. But yeah, we are starting with the first part of the second verse, but I also wrote on the top of the sheet paper, I also wrote when you play which parts, just if it's confusing for you. But let's start with part A of the second verse. Once again. So it's just going up. Yeah, that is how you play part A, and part B goes like this. This is part B and part C. And then we have part D, which goes like this. You do a slide at the beginning to like get right into it. So this was the second verse. I don't play it again completely, because otherwise the video will be about 1 hour at the end, and some of you wrote that also in the comments that my videos are way too long. So you have the sheet paper, just learn the different verse parts, and later on you can just check out where you have to play which part and something like this. So after the second verse part, we are going into the chorus. I think it's the chorus, but this is actually the most awesome part of the song to play. Actually, for me, it's my favorite part. I'm dividing it in only one part, because the melody is repeating itself. So I just play the melody one time for you, and it goes like this. This was the melody one time, and after that you play the same thing again. And maybe you noticed, when I play this A and after that the G, I do a little ornamentation there. I do a cut on the A and then like doing a tap on the G, so you have like. It's a nice ornamentation. Of course you can play different ornamentation in the whole song, like how you like it, but yeah. This was the melody of this chorus part. Now I will play the whole chorus, so playing this melody two times in a row, and it goes like this. Sorry about this two little mistakes over there. You know, I get kind of nervous when I'm in front of the camera, you know? It's like my casting couch. And then I get a little bit shy in front of the camera. I'm really sorry, I will just play the chorus again for you. It goes like this. This was actually the whole chorus, and I forgot a part. I just realized now. At the end you play. I also put it on the sheet paper, so I play the chorus once again. As you can see, the video will take 1 hour because of all my mistakes anyway. I'm really sorry. So the chorus part all completely together goes like this. This was the whole chorus part. After this part, you have the first verse again, but you already learned that one, so we are going to the break part. And after the break part, we are finished. Then I will just write you down which parts in which row will follow, and then I play the whole song with a backtrack together. But for now, let's go to the break part, the last part of the song. Yay! Okay, so the break, last little bit of the song, divided this one in part A, B, and C. And actually, I know I told you before that you don't have to play the G-sharp twice, you only have to play it one time. Remember, it was this half note over here. But I'm sorry, in the part A of the break, you have to play the G-sharp again. But you already learned that one in the intro, so you have mastered it and you can play it now. Congratulations. Hopefully. We are starting with part A of the break. You're starting on an F sharp, and there we do a little nice ornamentation. We do a slide over there, because the hole over there on the F sharp is slippery and wet, and your finger is like slippering away. Is this the right word? In German we would say wegrutschen. Wegrutschen, ja. Der Finger rutscht über das Loch. That's the right term in German. Okay, but we play the part A of the break. Goes like this. This was part A, as you heard also at the end. I do a little slide. You can just do it as you want. I play the part A of the break again, goes like this. Yes, this was part A of the break, and now we are playing part B and part C of the break. And there you have to be careful, because it sounds a little bit like the first verse, and it is the first verse, but you play it in a different kind of tempo, and you play it in a different kind of how you say that. It's just another arrangement how you play it, and also some notes are changing there, so be careful. I will just play it for you, and you can also check it out in the sheet paper. Let's start with part B of the break part. Once again. This was part B, and now part C. Once again, part C. Some of you may not notice that there are some changes in the notes, but there are, especially this part. There you have the change to the first verse part, so it's almost the verse part, but it's actually not. Yeah, this was actually the whole song. So we learned the intro. We learned a first verse, we learned a second verse, we learned a chorus, we learned a break part. Yeah. I guess that was everything. Yeah, now I will play the whole song together with the backtrack, but first of all, I write you down here which parts will follow in which row, so it's a little bit easier for you. Okay, so the whole song structure, when it comes out to my mind, is like this. First, you have the intro, then you have the first verse, then you have the second verse with part A, B, C, and D. After that, you are going to the chorus. After that, you are going to verse 2, which only has the part B. After that, you have the break part. After that, you have the verse 2 again, which has only the part A. And after that, you have the chorus again, and at the end, you have the first verse again. And this is the whole song structure in the row, how you play it. And also a little addition, at the end, when you play the first verse again for the last bit of the song, you play it two times. You play part A, part B, then part A, and on the second time you play part B, you play the whole part B of the first verse, but then for the end you take the last notes from the part B as the end, to end the song. How this will sound, I will actually play it now for you as a little addition before going to the backtrack. Goes like this. So I also made a red mark over there in the sheet paper when I played the last bits, the last notes. Hopefully this was understandable for you. But yeah, this was the whole Grimner in Fallen Jätte song. I really hope that this tutorial was not too confusing. I really try to like make it better and not so confusing, but sometimes, especially for these songs, my mind just gets crazy and I don't know how to get control over it, but for the next time, the next video will be a little bit easier, maybe a song, there are still some songs left. I got some requests for the Bart song from what is the band? Blind Guardian, yeah, and also some other songs I have to finish, but hopefully, for now, you have enough to learn new awesome song. Sorry to Grimner if I made mistakes on that or if it was confusing for you as well. But really, I hope that you like this video. Anyway, write down in the comments what I could do better, what songs you want to learn in the future. Give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and hopefully see you next time. Your Hylianmusik. Bye bye. Cheers.